My name is Adam Briggle. I live at 1315 Dartmouth Place in Denton, and I want to mention that this event is being live tweeted at hashtag PassTheBan. That's hashtag PassTheBan. Okay, I'll touch on the costs and benefits of fracking in my three-minute talk. Sadly, the people of Denton know all too well the costs. They know it by McKenna Park. They know it where a blowout forced the evacuation of homes. They know it near UNT where fumes cause headaches and nausea. And they know it where Miley lives. When we do cost-benefit calculations, we tend to only include what's easy to count. We don't count the externalized costs. We don't count the lost peace of mind for parents worrying about their kids. What is it worth to feel safe in your home? We've got to put that on the scales, too. Of course, the industry ignores the costs and speaks only about the benefits. Like big tobacco, they play the denial game. Now, I'm not sure we should take economic advice from the industry. In 2 weeks, as you can see here, they wasted more money on a meaningless, annoying political stunt than it cost to install a vapor recovery unit, which would reduce toxic emissions in Denton for years. But fine, you know what? Let's play by their rules. They talk about how fracking is a windfall for Texas, yet Denton has done far more than its part for the state's economy. Even if we crammed all of Texas's gas wells into the 7% of the state that is urban, Denton would still host more than three times the number of wells as the average city in that scenario. And even when the ban is in place, we'll continue to do our part for the state's economy with all of our wells still in production. They also talk about how fracking is a boom for Denton's economy, but that's a lie. Though we do more than our fair share for the state, we get little in return. Tax revenues from Denton gas wells total less than 1% of the city's budget. The mining sector employs just 0.27% of Denton's workforce. Indeed, fracking is a drag on our economy. Gas well infrastructure makes new development more costly, and the skilled workforce we want to attract is looking for places with a high quality of life. Poisonous fracking 200 feet from your home doesn't quite fit that bill. They'll find jobs elsewhere. Now, most of the mineral wealth from Denton gas wells goes to outsiders. Fracking operators, none of which are based in Denton, take over 70%. Absentee mineral owners take 20% more. Denton families own just 2%. Even according to the industry, the cost of the ban will amount to a mere fraction of a percent of Denton's budget. Yet all they talk about is how much revenue we stand to lose. In so doing, they are treating us like just another commodity. They're putting a price on our health and safety, our right to enjoy our property, and the livability and character of our Denton. These are the costs of not banning fracking. What are these things worth to you? And why do they think we'd sell them so cheaply? Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Briggle, I believe we had a question from Councilmember Roden.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dr. Briggle. Appreciate your presentation. And certainly, no matter what people think on this particular issue, you've spent an enormous amount of time these last, really, 3 years helping the city and advising the city. So I just want to publicly thank you for thank you. All you've done to help everyone in the city understand this. It's really a true role as a professor in our community. So thank you for that.
Thank you.
You mentioned the production fracking distinction, and just for everyone's education, from the point of view of the ordinance being presented to us tonight, it is calling for a ban of fracking, but how will that, if it will at all, affect existing producing wells? Do those get shut down and everything just stops, or can you explain that distinction?
Right. No, that's not the case. This ban would not turn off some spigot on producing gas wells. Those wells would continue to produce. The royalties that they're producing would continue. The distinction is they could not go in and refrack those wells at a future date, right?
And what are you hearing out there? I mean, a lot of people want to paint this as just a bunch of liberal crazies that are supporting this ban, but you've been out there collecting signatures. And again, for our point of view, because we've got to make a decision tonight, is that the case? I mean, demographically, what are you seeing in terms of talking to the people and their feeling on this particular subject? Because imagine folks gathering petition signatures have a good pulse on the feeling of our city at this point.
Yeah, I tell you what, this is not a partisan issue. This is about the health and safety of your children and your neighborhood, and that's something everybody gets behind. That's what we've seen. I also want to say about the liberal comment you made, certainly not the case that everybody's liberal by far. There's a lot of conservatives behind this because really what we're doing is talking about protecting property rights, which is a founding principle of conservatism. And we also have a lot of libertarian supporters who are in favor of small government because government doesn't get any smaller than the city level. Right.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Councilmember Gregory.
Dr. Briggle, thank you also. I want to express my thanks because of the ongoing research that you've done. Must have spent hours and hours, and the effort that you've made to educate all of the folks in town about this. Do you have these slides that you've presented in a printed form, or can you get those in a printed form?
Yeah, I can get those to you, and I should mention that this is a paper that I'm working on with Professor Matthew Fry, who's in the Geography Department at UNT, which is currently under peer review. The nice thing about these numbers, though, there's open source. Everybody can go to the Denton Central Appraisal District and find the same numbers. But, yeah, I'll get this to you for sure.
But I appreciate the work and the research.
Yeah, thank you.
Councilmember Engelbrecht.
Thank you, Mayor. First off, I want to thank you for the work you've done over the years. And I know you started out trying to bring various parties together and get information from all sides. I know you had more than one meeting at open meeting to the community, hosted at UNT. You brought in industry representatives. You brought in those opposed to drilling, etc. And you brought in some environmentalists to talk about the whole nature of the environment and air quality in Denton. What brought you to the point that you moved from sort of providing information and working with the community to going, I've had it, I'm going to go work towards a ban?
Well, I'll tell you immediately, and then I'll step back a bit. The immediate moment was when I was handing out flyers in Miley's neighborhood, and I saw a school bus dropping off kids right next to that fracking site. And I saw moms grab their hands and run home as quickly as they could because they were scared of it. And I said, what if that was Gracie or Lulu, right? My kids. So that was the immediate moment. Now, if you step back, it was after years when we crafted this ordinance working together, and it's right, I brought in the industry. I invited Ed Ireland to give a talk in my class, and we had John Tintera give a talk for DAG, the group. And we worked hard at it, and then we adopted an ordinance with a 1,200-foot setback, and then fracking happens at UNT closer than that. Fracking happens down at Southridge closer than that. Fracking happens in Miley's neighborhood. And then we discover all of these plats where fracking has already been permitted on 30% of the land area of the city. And we realize this is going to happen again and again and again. And this strategy of trying to make it compatible with other areas in town just won't work. I mean, in our city code, we don't even let a bakery set up in residential areas. But here we have this heavy industry. It just doesn't make sense. When you come down to it, that's the problem.
Thank you, Dr. Briggle. Thank you very much for yeah. speaking. Thank you. Bry?
My name is Matthew Fry. I live at 1600 Highland Park Road here in Denton. Since the early 2000s, a consistent claim has been that fracking benefits local economies. Early claims relied on the predictive powers of economic models. However, after over a decade of fracking in Denton, we have firsthand knowledge and data that can be used to empirically test some of those early claims. There are five main ways that the money from fracking could benefit people in Denton. Predictions by the industry suggested that drilling operations and royalty payments would create jobs and generate economic spillovers. For example, the Perryman Group predicted 5.92% growth in private employment. However, peer-reviewed studies by economists found much lower figures, with only 1.5% economic gains. Moreover, economists have argued that industry-supported studies are misleading and offer questionable estimates. For Denton, we still don't know exactly how much the local economy has been affected, but it's worth noting that none of the operators who have worked in the city have headquarters or offices based in Denton. And although a few affiliated companies have offices in Denton, the number of Denton jobs directly related to gas production is limited, with the mining sector accounting for a fraction of local employment. And though there may be spillover jobs, it's hard to separate these from jobs created by DFW's rapid urbanization. A recent study shows that increases in mineral property taxes allowed rural areas in the region to increase their spending on education. However, in cities where there are more surface properties, the share of taxes that come from the mineral properties is much lower, as in Denton, where mineral property taxes amount to just 1% of the total property tax revenue. Supposedly, more and cheaper gas should reduce the prices of consumable commodities produced with that gas. However, this past May marked the third time in 3 years that Atmos Energy increased rates in Denton. Thus, fracking in Denton has not led to lower costs for Denton's gas consumers. Although data on royalties is difficult to obtain, county tax appraisal data can be used as a proxy for Denton's royalty payments. My current research and preliminary results with Dr. Briggle show that at least 60% of Denton's mineral owners do not live in the city, and they receive at least 60% of the value of the royalty payments. Thus, the majority of the royalties are not funneled back into Denton's economy. And those are the royalty owners who own all the royalties on Denton's wells and where they're located. In terms of local mineral owners, over 600 Denton residents who own minerals receive just 7.3% of total value of minerals. It's 2% if the share of the royalties that go to the operators is factored in. Otherwise, family trusts and the city control the largest share of Denton's minerals. And as you can see, the city uses its gaspill royalties to fund a number of different projects. And so those are the royalty owners' location in Denton, and those are the gas wells in the city limits. Last slide. Finally, economic studies rarely factor into the monetary cost of drilling. In Flower Mound, property values decrease within 1,000 feet of wells. In Denton, many homes are closer than 1,000 feet, and new homes can be built 250 feet from gas wells. And a growing number of peer-reviewed empirical studies estimate medical expenditures associated with fracking. To conclude, while Denton has experienced some monetary benefits from fracking, the benefits do not appear to be as substantial as some are arguing. We also know that the primary economic beneficiaries are not based in Denton. And although rarely discussed, there are real economic costs associated with this activity. Thank you.
Councilmember Gregory has a question.
Yes.
Do you have a hard copy of that that would be available for us?
It will be. It's being reviewed right now.
And it's what?
The article's being reviewed right now, so the
okay.
data. Yeah.
And I saw what I appeared to be a few footnotes at the bottom with your sources.
Yeah, I can share that with you, too.
Well, that would be helpful.
Yeah.
We're getting an awful lot of, as you've noticed tonight, rather different data being presented to us as factual. And so... data with those footnotes with the sources is very helpful in terms of us making reasonable decisions.
Yeah, there's several studies. There's some recent studies, too, with the setback distances that mm-hmm. you asked about earlier, and several researchers have found. One researcher was claiming 1.5 miles distance from wells where they're seeing health impacts, and other ones are claiming about 0.5 miles. And so
I mentioned
that earlier.
I was particularly yeah. interested in the backup on that particular
yeah.
piece
no,
of data.
No, I'm happy to share those.
Thank you very much.
We have a quick question. Councilmember Roden.
Yes.
You think it's quick? No, it is. I just want to clarify. I've heard these two stats. So there's 2% of royalties that go to Denton families, but you also had 7.2 or 7.3, and the difference there was when you account for what goes to the operator. Is that what you said?
Yeah, so when you look at the DCAD data, there's they have royalty interest, so the people, the mineral owners, and then they have a working interest. And the working interest is what's divided out and goes to the actual operators. And that is about 75% of the total interests in the city. And so that to me is can be factored out of this equation, because that kind of goes with the costs of what they're doing. Right? And so that's where it comes in. So it's a 2% factor when you factor in that 75% working interest. In
super helpful. Thanks for your work.
Yeah.
As Councilmember Gregory echoed, I mean, we're getting an onslaught of this. I mean, folks are sending this to our doors. So perhaps some folks can come up with $40,000 to do the same with a different economic study to send out to folks as well. But that's helpful information, so I appreciate it.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you.